Hello, you magnificent almost 500 subscribers to my channel. I really appreciate your support. Today's video is going to be all about how you can set up your own customized version of columns in the Facebook Ads Manager so that you've got all the information that you need at your fingertips. Let's jump into it. Hi there, I'm Rod. I'm the founder of Rod Blaine Agency. I'm an e-commerce veteran. I ran my own e-commerce business for about 16 years, almost 17 actually. Sold it to my competitor a couple of years ago. Now what I do is help people with their Facebook and Instagram marketing. We help people create, set up, optimize, and just do better with running their ads and their websites in general. If you enjoy my content, this one or any other content on my channel, I'd really appreciate it if you went ahead and hit the like button and click subscribe. That really does help me out a lot and lets the YouTube algorithm know that you'd like more content like this. So today I'm going to show you how you can set up a customized version of metrics columns in the Facebook Ads Manager that's applicable for both e-commerce and for lead generation. So let's jump on the computer. So this is the standard interface for the Facebook Ads Manager that you would most likely see. This is one of our client accounts, so I've got some of the information grayed out for their privacy. The default set of columns is called performance. It does include some useful information such as the number of results, and that will vary depending on what type of campaign it is that you're running and the cost per result and how much you've spent. Purchases, if you're in e-commerce, that's probably relevant as well. But there's a lot of information that is missing that would be really handy to have. So I'm going to show you a customized setup, which I've created before. So once again, I have the results up front and center. Now, the reason I have that one is because sometimes the event that you're optimizing your ads for, it might be set incorrectly. I've seen this before where if the result here is say ads to cart, then your ad set isn't actually set up properly. If you have an e-commerce business that you're doing ads for, then you definitely want to be optimizing for purchases in most cases. We've got the cost per result. Then we've got how much you've spent on the campaign so far. So the default range is going to be this month, and you can alter that just by clicking up there if you want to. Then we've got the purchases conversion value. So how much the value is of the purchases that have been generated by this campaign so far. We've got the return on ad spend. As you can see, that's a metric that is based on the total conversion value, and then it's divided by the amount that's been spent. Then we've got the cost per purchase. That's your total amount spent divided by the number of purchases. You can see the daily budget, and we can see how many checkouts have been initiated. It's got 329 checkouts initiated. We've only got 65 purchases. Now there is delays with sales attribution. Sometimes you might need to look at not the past immediately prior to today. You might need to go back a week and then look at the date range from a week and then prior to that, so that Facebook catches up on all the attributions. And we have the number of ads to cart and the cost per ad to cart. Then we've got the conversion value of the ads to cart as well. So you can see that's almost $20,000 in terms of the cart value, but there's only about $10,000 of that is actually converted to a purchase. Then we've got CPMs, which is short for cost per milli, or it's the average cost per 1,000 impressions for your ad. And then outbound clicks. I find that's useful to know how many clicks have been generated that go off Facebook from the ad, especially for e-commerce. Then we've got the outbound click-through ratio. So if you just use the standard click-through rate, you might see that this is actually quite high, and I don't think it's all that useful. I think it's much more useful to see what the outbound click-through rate is. Then you've got your cost per outbound click, and then the reach. So that's the number of people that have actually been reached by your ad, and the number of impressions. Then the frequency is how many times the same person has seen the same ad during the reporting period. So in the space of 16 days, it's on average around about 4 times each person that's seen the ad has been shown it. Then you've got your comments and post engagements. So that's the full setup. And now I'm going to show you how you can set these columns up from scratch. So I'm back in the Ads Manager now in my demonstration account, and I'm going to select the default set of columns, which is for performance. And then I'm going to customize these columns. Just to make things simpler, I'm going to delete all of the columns that are already there, and I'm going to add in the ones that I want one by one. So the first one I want is results, and then I want to have my cost per result. You need to look for a column, just type in the word, then you can select cost per result. And then we want the amount spent, and then we want the number of purchases. So for that, I'm just going to use total, I say when you add one in, it adds in more granular options. You're not going to need all these other options. So I just turn those off and it just shows you overall purchases. Now let's look at the next column. So the total and also the conversion value is going to be in the next one. Once again, we're going to turn off all those granular options. Next, we want the return on ad spend, or ROAS for short. So just select the total there. Once again, turn off the granular options. And I want the cost per purchase next. I didn't actually select that, but I'm going to select it now. So notice as you select each option, it just adds it to the bottom. Next, I like to have the budget. That's the next one down. And I want some of the checkout information. So I'm working my way up the funnel. So from conversion, purchase, next is checkout. So I want the total number of checkouts initiated. And then I also want the cost per checkout initiated. Then I want the value. Next, I'm going to put in ads to cart. So I want the total ads to cart, and then I want the cost per ad to cart. And then I also want the conversion value for ads to cart as well. So once again, I'm just going to deselect those granular options. Now we're getting down to the end. So CPM, and then I also want the click information. So you see there's lots of options for click. I want outbound clicks, and I want the outbound click-through rate. And I also want the cost per outbound and click as well. So that's added those ones on, and then I'll use delivery. So I can see whether the ad or campaign is currently delivering at the moment. And now we've just got the last six or so reach, and then impressions, and then frequency, and post comments, and post engagement. So if you wanted to save that as a preset, you click on save as preset, and then you need to put in a name there. You click on apply. And now when you go back to your column, you've got your newly customized column that you can refer back to. If you are an agency and you're managing multiple clients, as long as you've got your client ad account attached to your business manager, you can easily duplicate this setup in different client ad accounts just by changing the ad account customized columns. And then you just need to save that column arrangement again. So that's the setup for e-commerce. Now I'm going to run through a setup for lead generation. So here's the setup for lead generation. So as before, we've got results and cost per result. Always like to have that at the beginning of the columns, how much you've spent, the number of leads that were generated. If you did have a conversion value associated with your leads, if you've set up a custom conversion event, you would want to have that there. Otherwise you could just leave it out. Your daily budget, your CPMs, the outbound click through rate, the cost per outbound click, the delivery, the reach and impressions. The rest of it is very similar to the e-commerce setup, frequency, post comments, and post engagement. So now I'm going to take you through how to set that up from scratch. So I'm back in the demonstration ad account again, and I'm going to go back to the default performance setup, and then we go down to customize columns. As I did before, I'm just going to delete everything that I've got in there. Then I'm going to start from scratch, just in case you've skipped forward to this part of the video. So the first thing I want is the results, and then I want the cost per result as well. And then I want the amount spent, and then I want the number of leads since we're interested in lead generation. Then I'm also after the conversion value for the lead. So once again, I'm going to deselect these granular options, which aren't as useful, probably something that you're not that interested in. Next, we've got the budget, and then your CPM, your cost per milli, or the cost per 1,000 impressions. Then I'm interested in the outbound clicks. So I'll just type in outbound. So we want outbound clicks, the outbound click through rate, and the cost per outbound click as well. Next, we've got delivery, and then reach. Then we've got impressions, and then frequency. And finally, I've got comments. Always like to see if ads are getting a lot of comments, and it's always good to pick up anything not desirable so you can fix that. Post engagement. So now we're going to save it as a preset, and I'm going to do like I did before. So lead ads, let's put version 2 because I've already saved one of these. Then you click on apply. Now what you should have is a couple of custom columns. You can switch to the e-commerce specific one that I've created before. Now I can switch to the lead ads one as well. That's it for today's video. Hopefully you found that useful. If you did, please go ahead, hit the like button, click subscribe. I really appreciate that. And in case you missed it at the beginning of the video, my agency helps people create, optimize, and do a lot better with their Facebook and Instagram advertising. If you'd like to have a chat with either myself or someone in my team about that, and we've got an opening because we've got limited numbers of clients that I like to work with at one time, then there'll be a link in the video description below. You can click on that. You can book a time to have a chat with somebody. We can talk about what your business is, what you're doing at the moment. You can get a bit more of an understanding of how we work, what the pricing is, etc. And who knows, we might end up working together. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.